ZoomText is a screen magnification software. It allows you to zoom in progressively larger, up to times 26. It's for students with low vision, and it also allows you to do things like change the background color. So you can do yellow and black, do something like a black on white, or you can go to and invert the blacks and the whites to give a gray scale background. You can also change the pointer to make it easier to follow along with. So I'm going to change it to yellow with a red cross. You can follow along underneath, or you could do giant green. Makes it easier to follow along for students with low vision. I'll show how it works with Internet Explorer on times 5 magnification. Engaging students with the community. Only to possess knowledge and intellectual capacities. Okay. Hi, my name is Brett. I'm going to show you how I use the Kurzweil text reader to read textbooks while I'm at college. So I've got the Paul voice chosen. I'm going to start reading the textbook, which is an anatomy textbook.
The heart is a four-chambered organ slightly left of the sternum.
That's a little bit too fast, so I'm going to slow it down to about 120 words a minute.
Sternum. The two upper chambers of the heart are the atria.
If I don't like the voice, I can change it to another voice, like Kate.
Atria. The two lower chambers of the heart are the ventricles.
As I go through, I can do something like highlight. So I can take the yellow highlight and highlight the word, the ventricles. I can take green and I'll go to the atria. I did too much there, so I'll erase it. And get the atria to highlight. Or add a footnote or a sticky of the heart. I can zoom in, going up to about 400%. If I need to look closer, go back out to 150%. Can go through and look up definitions, synonyms, syllables, jump around pages quickly, so. And as you can see, the text notes are still there, so I can go later on and extract them, and it'll come to a file for me. So everything I'll highlight will come out. The next thing I can do is show them side by side so I can look at how the text compares to my notes. So tile vertically and see my notes here, go over and find where it is in the text itself. And I can have Kurzweil read for me out of my notes.
Atria, the ventricles.
So it'll go through and it'll read either my notes or go back and read parts of the text. I can also add voice notes for myself if I have a microphone to do so. I really love Kurzweil because it allows me to read books at a faster speed. It will read it to me while I'm studying and it helps me focus a lot better. And another thing, it really helps when professors choose their textbooks early so that I can get my textbook turned into an electronic form so that I can read it on time for class.
Here we're at the homepage of the Cal State Long Beach.
Click University New.
And JAWS will read pretty much everything. You can tell it to move by link.
Bullet link by CSULB. Bullet link webmail. Bullet link directory.
By visited link.
Visited link CSULB. Visited link beachboard.
And these are all shortcut keys on the keyboard, so your keyboard becomes like a dashboard, if you will, to tell Jaws where to go.
Pause dialog, links list dialog, links list view, library 17 of 113.
And so there, and there's all the links. You can just use the arrow keys to move through the links.
Correct, skip link.
Compose it for you.
Student, faculty.
So you can also move my graphic, so if you want to see what pictures are on this page. With the letter G on the keyboard.
Link graphic medical advisory.
So that's a link with a picture and alt text of medical advisory.
Link graphic donate to CSULB.
There again is a link and a picture with alt text of donate to CSULB.
Link graphic CSULB budget central.
Budget central.
Graphic clouds.
JAWS is designed to be used without a monitor. So the screen reader's features allow me to use a computer with
Land.
And with accessible pages with alt-texted graphics, it makes navigating the web a lot more barrier-free.
CSULB, Land, visited link CSULB, Land, search CSULB, edit, search button, Land.
Right, it speaks everything on the page. It tells you there's an edit field, there's a button, it tells you everything you would possibly want to know to independently get information and do what you need to do. What I use often actually is a site index to get to, like, let's say a particular department or something. I would first, since I already know, let's say I want to look up something in the Department of Journalism, you would go into the site index.
JAWS dialog.
Hit J.
J, jobs at the beach. J, jobs at the beach. J, J.
So there it is. It's the link labeled J.
Enter.
I hit enter on it, it's loading the page.
J.
So now we're at J, and let's see, I can navigate to the link journalism, or if I know that the name of the link is journalism, JAWS has a special feature called JAWS Find. JAWS Find is you can type any text you want, and it'll look for it on the current screen. So why don't we do that?
Virtual Find. JAWS.
Virtual Find. I'll type in journalism, or for simplicity's sake, J-O-U-R.
J-O-U-R.
Hit enter.
Enter. Link JEZR left parent journal of electronic commerce research.
Now,
link job opening escape.
Do it again, let's see.
Link journalism.
There it is. So then we'll hit enter on it.
4%.
Okay.
100%. Department of Journalism with department.
So here we are, the Department of Journalism. Is it recording?
Depart this page link skip the content. Visited link graphic California list of 5 items. Bullet. Search CS edit.
And again, you can also navigate by heading level.
NAHJ chapter hold in fundraiser is third land.
So, in order to make it easier to navigate and to make information more accessible, I'd say that first, links, I mean, just, it's common sense in a way, make your website very easy to navigate by making the links' names have, you know, like, make sense. For documents, I'd say just to be safe, keep, if you can have a, if you can have a PDF version of a file, be nice to have a Word version of it too. I'd say for forms, same goes, you know, it'd be the simpler the better. Sometimes, you know, it's nice to have virtual forms with you know, hypertext with PDF. But if you can, a Word file form would be a lot easier.
I also use Dragon Naturally Speaking. It's a voice recognition software that types what I speak. It's getting better and better as time goes by and allows me to voice my thoughts when I can't type them. I'm going to demonstrate how Dragon will type what I'm saying. Today is Friday, December 4th. Period. This weekend I need to study for the upcoming finals. I have an anatomy final, a biology final, an English final, and a math final. Period. New paragraph. On Saturday, I'm going to study for the anatomy final. Period. After I finish studying for anatomy, I'm going to start on the math final. Period. As you can see, this tool is helpful for letting me get my work done in a timely manner.